Sir, you have muted yourself.
Now my it is audible.
Ah, yes.
Okay, okay, okay.
Sir, now it is.
Let us consider this one is your body. Okay, let us consider this one is your body. On this body, okay, now let us consider two forces are acting. Okay, now let us consider first force is P, second force is Q. See, on a body at a point represented in magnitude and direction by two adjacent sides. How we can represent to this? Say, I will change its color. Like this, okay, now I can represent it. I can represent like this also, okay, now their resultant is represented in both magnitude and direction by the diagonal of parallelogram which passes through the point of intersection of two sides representing the forces. See, suppose, see, I'll explain once again. Okay, let us consider this one is your body. Okay, now see, let us consider two forces are acting on this body. Let us consider the magnitude of force P, and this force magnitude is Q in the upper direction, means in slant direction. Okay, now how we can represent its resultant? Okay, now let us consider before going to calculate that resultant, first you have to draw the parallel sides. Okay, now like this. Okay, next its resultant will be, suppose if you draw its diagonal, na. Okay, now that becomes your resultant. Okay, wait for a minute, ma. Okay, can you able to see my mobile screen?
Yes, sir. Now.
Okay, okay. I will explain because I'm getting difficult while writing with the help of mouse. So I will write with the help of this one. Let us consider. See, listen. First, try to understand this. Okay. See, this law states that let us consider this one is your body. On this body, two forces are acting simultaneously. Okay, now simultaneously by two adjacent sides. Let us consider, I am considering its two adjacent sides, this one and this one. Okay, now how we are going to represent this resultant? We can represent its resultant by its diagonal. Okay, now diagonal, I will tell its physical meaning of resultant in next slides. Okay, let us consider this one is your P, this one is your Q. Okay, now Q force. Next, see, this one is your resultant R. Okay, now the angle between these two forces, I am considering it as theta. Okay, now the angle made by the resultant, I am denoting with the help of alpha. Can I write like this or not? Okay, the angle between two forces, that is theta, and the angle made by the resultant, I am considering it as a alpha. Okay, now see, I am drawing once again like here. This one is your resultant force. This one is your resultant force. Okay, now can I calculate this R value, ma? R resultant value. Is there any possibility to calculate this R value? Anyone, can you help me? How to calculate this resultant value? Anyone of you, rule number two?
We should draw right angle triangles.
Okay. I am drawing this perpendicular line from this point. Let us consider this one is your O point, A point, B point, C point. From the B point, I am drawing perpendicular here also. So I will get, this is my right angle triangle. Okay, now what is the angle of this one? This one is your is the alpha, and what about this one? This one is your theta. Okay, now see, this one is this. Initially, this one is your P, na. This one is your Q. Okay, na. From here to here, if it is Q, what about this one? Here it is also Q, na. If it is P, what about this one? This top side, this is also P. Okay. Now, Is it clear to all of you till this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now in the last class, okay, now try to recollect the last session. Okay. Now try to recollect that, ma'am. If it is theta and if it is alpha, what about this? What can I write, ma? This one, this thing. What can I write?
Beta.
This is P. This is Q. Array. This is Q, na? This is Q. Means this. This is cos also alpha. Theta. So that is Q cos alpha.
Q
not
cos theta.
Very good. Q cos theta. What about this one? This one is your.
Q sine theta.
Is it clear or not? Is there any doubt to anyone? Are
you no, clear?
I resolve this component. One is horizontal component and one is vertical component. Okay, now you people will have that this doubt, sir. Why you are writing this theta? Why not this alpha? Okay, see the angle between the two forces P and Q. What is the angle between two forces? That is Q. See, this is parallel to this one. Na? See, I am writing with the help of green color. See, this one. This is parallel to this. Okay. The angle between this to the horizontal is how much? Theta. Here also it is theta. Okay. Na? Now, according to the Pythagoras theorem, what we can write, ma? See, this one is your. Now, your. This one is your R. What about this one? Q sine theta. What about this one? Q cos theta. Is it clear to all of you? No doubt, na? Till this point?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Which
alpha,
one?
Ma? Sir.
Where?
Here. No,
theta only, right, na? Sir. Just here. Cos theta only, sir. Theta only here. Are theta, na? This force is parallel to this, na? See, angle made by this with respect to horizontal, it is theta. Here also it is same theta only because parallel, na? Are here it is.
But you wrote R, no, sir. R resultant, you wrote. The angle between resultant and the horizontal line is alpha.
This one alpha is your R.
Yes, okay, sir. Okay. That is alpha.
From yes, here sir, to here, this is total P plus Q cos theta. Now it is clear?
Yes.
Now
sir.
It is clear, na? Now, yes. According to the Pythagoras theorem, what we can write? Hypotenuse square is equal to adjacent square. P plus Q cos theta whole square plus Q sine theta square. Q sine theta square. It is clear to all of you? Okay. Expand it. It is similar to your A plus B whole square. Now what can I write here? A square means P square plus A square plus Q square. Cos square theta a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay, now ab means here b is q cos theta. Okay, now 2ab plus q square sine square theta. Can I write like this or not? Sine square theta. Okay, here I am unable to write, ma. Okay, now is it clear? This thing is clear. R equal to. Any doubt to anyone? R square equal to P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta plus Q square sine square theta. Q square sine square theta. Okay. Now, see here. Q square cos square theta plus Q square sine square theta. What can I take common? Q square can I take? Okay, now Q square. But sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So, finally, finally, what can I write? P square. Plus Q square plus 2PQ
cos theta.
Is it clear to all of you? Now, R equal to what can I write? R equal to square root of. Okay. R equal to square root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Is it clear? When we had to use this formula, if two non-collinear concurrent forces are acting on a body, then we can directly calculate with the resultant with the help of this formula. Is there any doubt, my, to anyone? how to calculate resultant when two forces, two non-collinear forces are acting on the body, then resultant force we can calculate with the help of this formula. Is it clear? Any doubt to anyone?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
All of you write down this thing in your notebook. Write down. I will give one minute time. You can able to see my desktop screen now?
No, sir.
One minute.
Now it's okay, sir.
Chalo, start writing. Draw this diagram. Draw this diagram and try to calculate the R value. Frame that equation faster. Don't simply sit and watch this. Okay, now try it. If you practice this now, then only you will get these things. Otherwise, it is very difficult. Over. Completed one. Rule number one.
Sir, it's was still one.
Right, faster. Rule number 73. Unmute your microphone. Rule number 73. How's that? Rule number 50. Over. Karthik.
Yes, sir.
Completed,
yes.
Any doubt on this law? Okay, na? Parallelogram law. Definitely, yes, this question will come in your university exam, because many time, okay, na? State the law of parallelogram. Means you have to write this definition and you have to draw these diagrams and you have to derive that R equation. Okay, next. Triangle law of forces. Wait, I'll share that screen so that I can explain. Now, can you able to see this whiteboard?
Yes, sir.
Now listen, ma. Triangle law of forces. Okay, now what is the meaning? If two forces are represented by their force vectors placed tip to tail. Let us consider this one is your force vector. Okay, now this I am calling it as a tail, and this I am calling it as a tip. Okay, now if two forces are represented by their force vector placed tip to tail, means like this. Okay, now two forces are there. Okay, now they're represented by means they are placed with tip to tail, and its resultant can be represented by first their resultant vector is directed from the tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. Means its represented this resultant it can be represented by tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. Okay, na? Like this also you can calculate by this triangle law. Okay, na? In the parallelogram law, already you have R equal to square root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha. Okay, na? In this one, it is a graphical representation of graphical method to calculate the resultant. Which law? That is triangle law of forces. Okay, na? If two forces are there, let us consider this one is your P force, this one is your Q force, then how to calculate the resultant? Tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. Okay, na? Tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. Like this, we can able to calculate the resultant force. Okay. Next. Once again, you want?
Yes, sir.
See, ma. Now, can you able to see this definition?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Rule number one. Read this. If two forces are represented by their force vector, okay, now let us consider this one is your P. This one is your P force, and this one is your Q force. Okay, now how many forces are there in this also? Two forces. Okay, now. By their force vector placed tip to tail. See, this one is your tail and this corner is your tip. Okay, now let us consider tip to tail, two forces are there. Okay, now their resultant is vector directed from the tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. Means how we can represent this resultant force? Tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. This is the graphical method. Let us consider two forces given to you. I will show you one problem, then you will get some idea. Okay, now listen, ma'am. Okay, how many forces are there here? Two forces. One is 4 newton, another one is 3 newton. Okay, now two forces are there. Okay, now I want to calculate its resultant. Its resultant by using parallelogram law. Okay, now how to calculate? You know that formula very well. R is equal to
P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha.
See, P means I am considering this. Okay, now because while deriving that equation, I have considered this is my P, and what about this one? This is my Q. Is it clear? Okay, now P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. What is the theta? Means the angle between two forces, now angle made between two forces, that we are calling it as a theta. What about this one? The angle made by resultant with respect to horizontal line, then that is alpha. Is it clear? Is it clear or not? Any doubt, ma'am? Resultant, you will get 5 Newton. Okay, na? Next, what about the alpha, ma? Tan alpha. Tan alpha. See, in this one, tan alpha, alpha means opposite side by, means tan theta, tan alpha equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Now tell me, what is the opposite side? Q sine theta divided by P plus Q cos theta. Is it clear to all of you? Are from this right angle triangle,
yes,
from this right angle triangle, what is the opposite side? This one is your opposite side is Q sine theta. What about adjacent side?
P plus Q cos theta.
P plus Q cos theta. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, na? Same thing I have written here. Okay, na? Tan theta. See, you have to remember in this manner, ma. Tan theta means sin theta by cos theta, na? But here, P plus Q cos
sir.
Theta, Q sin theta. Haan, tell me.
Your voice is low, sir.
Am I audible to all of you or
yes,
only
sir.
He's
yes sir, you are clear.
Yes sir, you are clear sir.
You are clear sir.
Yes ma, please
poor data, sir.
Turn off your incoming video so that you can listen.
Sir.
Please mute your microphone. Is it clear to all of you?
Sir, if we don't use earphones, sir, your voice is very low sir. So please tell to the students to wear earphones, use earphones.
Yes sir, it is.
Yes ma'am, please use earphones so that my voice will be clear to you, okay? Now is it clear to all of you how we can apply the parallelogram law, okay na? When
yes,
we
sir.
Can apply that parallelogram law, if two non-collinear forces, either the forces will be like this, or the forces will be like this, perpendicular also. Okay, na? No problem. But non-collinear. Suppose two forces are there, like this and like this, we cannot apply the parallelogram law. Is it clear?
Concurrent
now.
Also, sir.
Concurrent. Okay, na? It should be concurrent force system. Okay, na? Two concurrent non-collinear forces. Now, how we can solve the same problem by using triangle law? In this also, how many forces we should have? Two forces. We have to calculate that resultant force. How to calculate? Let us consider I am drawing first. See, graphical method I am saying. See, first we have to draw one P. Let us consider 4 Newton means I am considering 4 Newton as 4 Newtons as 4 centimeter. Okay, now 4 Newtons as 4 centimeter. Is it clear? Okay. What about this one? 3 Newton. Okay, now 3 Newton means I am considering as 3 centimeter. Okay, now 3 centimeter and this one is my 4 centimeter. What about this resultant? Tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector now. Okay, see this one is your resultant. Suppose if you join this point and let us consider this one is your A point, this one is your B point and this one is your C point. Suppose if you join A point to C point, then you will get, what you will get? You will get resultant force. Okay, now if you measure now, then you will get 5 centimeter. How much you will get? 5 centimeter. 5 centimeter equal to, because I have considered 1 Newton as 1 centimeter. 1 Newton as 1 centimeter. Now, 5 centimeter, suppose if I get means, what is the resultant force? That is 5 Newton. Is it clear? 5 Newton. What about the angle made by resultant to with respect to X? This is your alpha. You can measure with the help of protractor. Protractor. Is it clear? Any doubt, ma?
No, sir.
Okay. Next. We will solve one problem. Okay. See, this type of problems, okay, na? Directly come for 10 marks, ma, in your university exam. See. Three forces of magnitude 40 kilonewton, 50 kilonewton and 20 kilonewton are acting at a point O as shown in the below figure. Determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant force. What we have to calculate? Magnitude as well as direction of the resultant force. Okay, now how to calculate? I will explain that procedure. Okay. Which type of force system it is? Which type of force system? Rule number 6.
Concurrent.
Rule number 6. Lalit. Rule number 6. Rule number 10.
Sir.
Tell me, ma. Which force system it is? Rule number 10.
Concurrent.
Coplanar concurrent force system, na, because only in one plane. Okay?
Sir, I can't visible your screen.
Now?
Yes,
now sir. You can able to see?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I will solve this problem. How to solve? See, for 10 marks, ma, this type of questions will come in your examinations. Simple problem. See, the given force system is, let us consider this one is your this and this. Here it is 40 kilonewton. Next, this one is your 15 kilonewton. Next, this is the force it is acting with respect to horizontal, that is 60 degrees. 20 kilonewton. Okay. Next, this is the 60 degrees and it is making an angle 30 degrees with respect to vertical. Now it is clear. This is your question. This is your x-axis. This is your y-axis. Okay, now resolution of forces which we have discussed in the last class. Same thing I am going to apply. Now submission of all horizontal forces I am writing, ma. Now see, this one is your positive x-axis, this one is your positive y-axis. What about this one? Negative x-axis, this one is your negative y-axis. Okay, now submission of forces along horizontal. Okay, now submission of forces along horizontal. Now what can I write? Now I want to bring this 40 kilonewton to the horizontal. What can I write? 40 cos 60. Very good. 40 cos 60. Okay, now next term. What about this one? 15 kilonewton. Suppose if I bring this 15 kilonewton to horizontal. What?
How can we write 40 cos 60?
Array, sir, I want to bring this 40 newton along x-axis. Okay, now in the last class, I have given many examples. I told you people, okay, now I am spending this much time. Only to understand, okay, na? Because in the upcoming classes, you will ask this type of doubts. I know very well that thing, okay, na? That is the reason why I explained you on that day. Now tell me, still you have any doubt? How to write this 40 cos 60?
Yes.
See, this 40 newton is there, na? 40 kilonewton. Suppose if I make this right angle triangle, okay? Now tell me, what about this? This one is your opposite side, this one is your adjacent side. Okay. Now I want to calculate this opposite side. Sine theta equal to what can I write? Sine theta equal to sine 60 equal to what can I write, ma? Sine 60 equal to 40 by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, I don't know. 40 by hypotenuse. Now tell me. Sorry. Hypotenuse, I know. Opposite, I don't know. Opposite by hypotenuse is 40. Now opposite side, what can I write? 40 sine 60, na? Can I write 40 sine 60? In the same way, I want to calculate this adjacent side. Adjacent means horizontal one. Okay, na? Cos 60 equal to what can I write? Cos 60 equal to adjacent means I don't know. What is the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse, he has clearly given 40. Okay, how much? Adjacent by 40. Now tell me, adjacent equal to what can I write? Adjacent equal to 40 cos 60. Now it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Is there any doubt?
No, sir. Thank you.
If you have any doubt, then tell me, ma.
No, sir.
No doubt, na?
Yes, sir.
Next. Now tell me, what can I write to 15 kilonewton? Resolve that 15 kilonewton horizontally. Tell me. Minus 15 sine 30. Minus 15 sine 30 because theta is not there to that axis. Okay, na? See, my intention is to resolve the forces horizontally, but theta lies to the vertical axis. So that is 15 sine 30. Next, please mute your mute your microphones. Next, what about this 20 kilonewton? Minus 20 cos
theta.
Okay, now theta means here 60. Is it clear? Apart from these three forces, is there any force?
No, sir.
No force. Okay, now suppose if you solve this, okay, now in your calculator, then you will get how much? 2.5 kilonewton means I will write this. First one, you will get 20 minus 7.5 minus 10. Okay. So finally, you will get 2.5 kilonewton. Okay. Take its screenshot, ma'am. Take its screenshot. Okay, na? After that, you copy this. Completed? Take its screenshot.
Yes, sir.
Over now.
Okay,
now.
Sir.
No, listen. This one here, sigma h, finally what I had, just now I got that sigma h value is how much?
0.5
how much? 2.5 kilonewton. 2.5 kilonewton. I am writing as it is. Now, what about this one? Submission of forces along vertical axis. Okay, now tell me what can I write? 40 sine 60. Can I write 40 sine 60? This force, this one, 40 sine 60. Next, plus 15
cos 30.
Next, what about this one? Coming to this 20 kilonewton, minus 20 sine 60. Sine 60. Is it clear? Now, finally, you will get. Okay, now suppose if you calculate in your calculator. First value you will get 34.64 plus 12.99. Next, minus 17.32. Is it clear? So finally, sigma v value you will get 30.31. If you want, you can calculate. I will wait for 1 or 2 minutes. Okay, na? For timing, take it screenshot, ma. You practice at your home.
Sir, okay? After 4 sine 60, how can you take plus?
Which one? After 40 sine 60. See, the 15, suppose if I am resolving, I am going to resolve this 15 kilonewton vertically, this force will come here, na, ma. Okay? Means in the positive y direction only, na?
Yes.
That is the reason why I have written positive sign over there. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Any doubt to anyone? Take it screenshot. No, 30.31. Wait. I'll tell that physical meaning of resultant also. Wait for few minutes. Okay. Now, summation of V equal to how much, ma? Summation of V, 30.31. Just now you have got. Just now you have calculated this one. Okay. Now, how much? Submission of H equal to 2.5 kilonewton. Submission of V equal to 30.31 kilonewton. What is the meaning of this one, ma? Suppose a number of, let us consider this one is your body. Okay, now on this body, this one force and second force, and next this one is your third. Three forces are acting. Okay, see in the horizontal direction, the effect of force in the horizontal direction is how much? 2.5. Positive means it is acting in the net force acting in the horizontal direction, that is 2.5 kilonewton. Next, the effect of force system in the vertical direction, it is acting how much? 30.31 kilonewton. Okay, now in the horizontal we know, vertical we know. Okay, now how to calculate its resultant? 90 degrees. Again, we can use that parallelogram law. Okay, under root of p square plus q square plus 2pq cos theta. Cos theta means again here theta value is 90. Cos 0 is how much? Sorry, cos 90 is how much? 0. Okay, now so finally what we can write? Finally, R resultant square is equal to square root of summation of H square plus summation of V whole square plus 2PQ cos theta. Theta means again it is angle made by theta means 90 degrees means cos 90 is 0. No need to write. Now tell me ma, what is the value of this one? Suppose if you calculate, then you will get resultant force as 30.41 kilonewton. Okay, 30.41 kilonewton. That is the resultant force value. Resultant force value. Next, is it clear? Take its screenshot.
Sir, if we get a horizontal force negative, then we should take a negative side, no, sir? Direction, we should change the direction.
Obviously, we have to change its direction. Okay, now?
Yes.
Okay, now? I'll give that problem as your homework problem. Try to solve that problem. Okay? Okay?
Hello, sir. Is it a negative sign above y? Positive y?
Positive y. This one. See, I'm indicating with the help of green color. This one, ma?
Which one, sir?
Negative.
Yeah. Yeah, is it a negative sign above y?
Above y? No. There is no... Actually, with the help of that marker, might came. Okay, na? Only y. Positive y, that is. Okay, na? How we can write negative over there? Is it clear how to calculate resultant force? Is it clear to all of you or not?
Yes, sir.
No doubt, na, ma?
Yes, sir.
Now, can I rub this entire thing?
Sir, can you explain it once again?
Which one? This one resultant?
Yes, sir.
See, ma, this force, let us consider this is the force system. Okay, na? On this force system, number of forces are acting. Okay, na? We don't have any formula to calculate the for number of means concurrent force system, coplanar concurrent force system. Only if two forces are there, then we have formula. Okay, na? According to the parallelogram law of forces. Okay, na? So I am converting this entire force system. I am resolving this entire force system into two component. Means one is I am resolving along the horizontal side, resolving the forces along vertical direction. Okay, na? Suppose if I am resolving the horizontal direction, then I am going to get the value of sigma h 2.5, sigma v is 30.31. okay, now listen, the same force system. So r equal to what is the formula? R is equal to p square plus q square plus 2pq cos theta. Okay, na? So see, after resolving this entire force system, what I have just now, I got sigma H value, next sigma V value. Is it clear? Sigma H means, see, while deriving that parallelogram law, okay, na, sigma H I have considered as P, na, sigma V I have considered as Q. Okay, the angle between this sigma V and sigma H is how much? 90 degrees. Okay, na? So square root of 2.5 square plus 30.31 square plus, this one is a plus, 2PQ. 2PQ means again same value. Cos 90 value is how much? My cos 90 value? 0. Means it entire term becomes 0. Okay, now this square plus this square, how much? 30.41 kilonewton. Okay. Now it is clear.
Sir,
now listen. This is your force system, given question. Next to this one is your 20 kilonewton, 60 degrees, next to this one is your 60 degrees. Now just listen first. Okay, now just now we got what we got resultant value now 30.41 means 30.41 means both sigma h value we got positive, sigma v value also we got positive, means the resultant will be lies in the first quadrant now, means 0 to 90 degrees, means somewhere here. Okay, now means this one is your alpha value. Is it clear or not? The angle made by resultant. Okay, now the angle made by the resultant. What? Hello?
Mummy got.
Yes, ma. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Now, see this alpha we have to calculate. How to calculate this alpha? Tan alpha equal to sigma v by sigma h. Can I write? Okay. What is the sigma v? Just now we calculate sigma h also. We calculated. Okay. Is it clear? Any
yes,
doubt, Vamshi?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt. Now, can anyone tell me what is the meaning of resultant now? Resultant force. Are resultant force already I told you now. It is a single force which can replace the given force system. See, resultant force, it is a single force. Okay, now how many forces we got? Only this single force. Which can replace the given force system, okay? Or which it will produce the same effect as the force system. Is it clear or not? Resultant force means it is a single force which can replace the given force system or produces the same effect as the original force system. Is it clear? This is the
yes,
meaning
sir.
Of resultant force. Okay. Any doubt, ma? If you have any doubt regarding this, you can ask me. Okay. Any doubt, ma, in this problem?
No, sir.
No, na. Next. Can you able to solve this problem? This is your homework problem. Can you able to solve this or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes.
Na, simple only now. Okay. Wow. Total 44 members are there now. Rule number 27. Respond
sir.
To me fast. Rule number 27.
Sir.
Now tell me. Suppose if I want to calculate the horizontal forces, I want to resolve the horizontal forces, what can I write? 15 cos 15, can I write? Please mute your microphones, others.
Okay.
15 cos 15, can I write?
Yes, sir.
That is positive side only. What about this 60? 60 cos 40, can I write? That is also positive only. What
yes,
about
sir.
This one? 40 minus 40 sine 35.
Yes, sir.
Minus 40 sine 35, can I write?
Yes, sir.
Because I want to bring this inclined force to horizontal na.
Yes, sir.
Next, what about this 70?
Yes, sir.
Minus 70 only. Suppose
yes,
if
sir.
You are writing, there will be no theta nama over there. Okay, na? Direct you can write 70. What about the vertical forces? 15?
15 cos.
Are sine.
Okay,
theta,
sir.
Theta is not lying na there. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Next, rule number 30. 30, please respond. Rule number 30. Are you there?
Naga Chaitanya.
Nayano. Udit, 23. Sir, already time is 10:23. Respond me fast. See, I'll explain. Listen. 15 sine 15, can I write vertical components? Plus 15 sine 15 plus 105. What about this one? Minus 16 sine 40. What about this one? Minus 40 cos 35. Is it clear?
Sure.
Any doubt, ma? After calculation of that sigma s, sigma v, then r value. R, how to calculate that resultant? Square root of summation of horizontal forces square plus summation of vertical forces square. Next, what about this problem? This is also same only, na? Any doubt? Any doubt?
No,
sir. If you have any doubt, okay, na? These two problems are your homework problem. When can I expect this?
20.
Okay, na? Same, do practice these two problems and WhatsApp me. Okay, na? Individually. Sir, okay, na? By mentioning your roll number.
Can
tell
you
me.
Please change the next slide, sir, so that I with can take this the
screenshot. I will share you, no problem. Okay, na? I will share these two photos in your group. Okay, na? After solving these two problems, WhatsApp me separately. Okay, na? Okay, na? Don't post any answer in your group. Okay, na? Okay, na? But don't forget to mention your rule number. Okay, na? In the message.
Okay,
ma. Okay, ma. Thank you to all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay,
thank you,
if you have, meanwhile, if you have any doubt, you can call me directly. Okay, na? No problem for me. Okay, na? Don't keep any doubt with you. I know it is very. Please mute your microphone, Vishal. Vishal. See, I know. In the beginning, it is somewhat it will be new to you, okay, na? But if you practice, na, it will be very easy only, okay, na? It is very okay, ma. Thank you to all of you. Already time is 10:25. Okay, thank you. Join that next meeting.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, ma. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thanks, sir.
Sir, attendance is downloaded.
Oh, already I had downloaded, ma.